Congress leader Shashi Tharoor was on Thursday granted interim bail by a Delhi court in the Sunanda Pushkar death case. The Patiala court granted him bail on a surety of rupees 1 lakh and said that he can't leave the country without the court's permission. On Saturday, Tharoor will be appearing before the court and will apply for regular bail as per the procedure, said his lawyer. The senior Congress leader has, however, maintained that he is innocent of charges leveled against him, but the Delhi court found sufficient grounds to proceed against him. The police had filed a 3,000-page charge sheet before Metropolitan Magistrate Dharmain Singh Tharoor under sections 498A and 306 of the Indian Penal Code. In the charge sheet, the police had named Tharoor as the only accused, while also alleging that he had subjected his wife to cruelty. IBM has been awarded a landmark $1 billion whole-of-government contract to be a major technology partner with the Australian government for a term of 5 years. The agreement, the biggest ever negotiated by Australian government, involves cross-branded solutions with IBM hardware, software and cloud-based solutions, and includes innovation programs in cybersecurity research and quantum computing. The deal was made with the aim to further the government's digital transformation agenda and to leverage its buying power to achieve better pricing across all departments and agencies, according to an announcement made by Human Services Minister Michael Cannon. All government agencies will be able to access certain technologies under the agreement, and agencies that currently partner with IBM, including the Department of Human Services, ATO, Department of Home Affairs and Defense, will see an improvement in their current contract arrangements, according to the government. IBM Australia Managing Director David La Rose said the agreement reflected the growing importance of tech to the government's transformation agenda. Billionaire Mukesh Ambani has launched a wired broadband service, Jio Giga Fiber, at the 41st Annual General Meeting of Reliance Industry on Thursday. The company has already invested more than $250 million in the industry. We will now extend the service to 1,100 cities to offer the most advanced fiber-based broadband services. This will mean a faster internet experience, said Chairman and Managing Director of RIL Mukesh Ambani. The scheme offers direct fiber connectivity all the way to the house. Unlike traditional fiber networks that offer connectivity to the house via traditional cables leading to the slow speeds, the move is seen as an attempt by the industry giant to further expand its operations across various sectors, particularly telecom, reports suggest. Also, various reports have indicated that the Reliance Group would probably invest around 60,000 crore this year alone into the telecom unit, likely to support the launch of the broadband plan. And with this, we have to come to the end of today's news on ASN Live. Stay tuned for more updates.